Okay, we're back. Tusculum leading 10-3 as we begin this second quarter. Tusculum will be on the attack. Goes low. Pioneers come up with the turnover. Ball free in front. And coming up away with it is Lees McCray. Bird with the shot. Saved by Geiger. Still going to be a ground ball pickup for Lees McCray. That's Ryan Bird. Tyler Finley. Back out to Bird, who scored the second goal of the contest for the Bobcats. In Tusculum leading 10-3 here in this second quarter. With Nate Raymond coming up with four goals. And coming up with the fourth goal of the night for Lees McCray.
Lees McCray goal scorer number 22.
Looks like Spence Combs coming up with the freshman from Magnolia, Texas. That makes the score 10-4. Still in favor of Tusculum. Again, Pioneer scoring 10 goals in the first quarter. Four by Nate Raymond, three by Lawrence Brown. And a goal each for Cale Lawrence, Tristan Kirkham, and Cody Webb, who gets his first goal. Another faceoff win by Lees McCray. Pioneers have dominated the faceoff so far tonight, winning 12 of them. Coming away with their fourth face-off win. Are the Bobcats trying to scratch back after being down 10-3 after the first period of play? Shot and a save by Ross Geiger. Goes to quick outlet. Tusculum. Sean Dunn comes up with the clear. Step back and set things up for the black and orange. Again, glad to have you with us here on the Pioneer Sports Network. Lees McCray in the road green, Tusculum in their home grays. Cale Lawrence sends it back out top. Tristan Kirkham. And guarded by Flanelli, who scored the first goal of the contest tonight. Nate Raymond sends it back. Jordan Daniel back up top. Off to Cale Lawrence. Quick shot. Antonio Cruz with the save. His eighth of the night. And back come the Bobcats, trailing 10-4. Tusculum 3-0 this season against Lees McCray, who's 0-3. We've opened with four straight matches against South Atlantic Conference teams. Quick pass by Flanelli, and Bird was not watching, and it was a quick turnover. And back come the Pioneers. But they're unable to come away with the successful clear. And still loose. Scooping it back deep into the attacking third is Lees McCray, and Tusculum will pick up the ground ball and they will attempt to reset. Teams exchange turnovers. Second one of the night for Tusculum. Third one of the evening for Lees McRae. And Tusculum will reset it, leading 10-4. Here with right at 10 minutes remaining in this first half. Behind the goal, over to Kale Lawrence on the side. Back out front, Jordan Daniel. Streaking Lawrence, Brown. That shot's deflected high into the air. Coming up with it is Kirkham. Kirkham will get it back to Wesley Phillips, and Phillips will set up the offense for TU. Back up top to the wing to Lawrence Brown. Brown being guarded. Shot and a goal by Lawrence Brown. A blast from 15 yards away. His fourth goal of the night. And his ninth of the season. And Tusculum leads 11-4.
On your goal by number 7, Lawrence Brown.
So we go on the faceoff. Still loose. No whistle. Still no one has it. And coming up with the pickup finally are the Pioneers. Now be Will Cookman making the pickup. Senior from British Columbia. Still free. Last touch by Lees McRae, and it'll go back to Tusculum. So really no possession. And Tusculum will maintain with 49 seconds remaining on the shot clock. John Dunn wide over to Aiden Caskey. Getting some action here in the first half. Caskey spins, back out to Lawrence. Lawrence to Dunn. Dunn with a shot, saved by Cruz. Save number 9 of the night for Antonio Cruz. With his team trailing 11-4. Ball is free as Dunn comes up with the dislodgement, but Lees McRae maintains the possession, and they'll go on the attack. That's Tyler Finley. He waits for numbers. He'll get it back out to Flanelli. Eventually, then back to Finley. So Finley will take it in. Back to Flanelli. Finelli shoots it wide left. 36 seconds remaining on the shot clock. 7:06 remaining in the second period. Tusculum leading 11-4. Spinning around is Galloway. They were looking for Finley. Back up top. Ferreter, and coming up with the save is Geiger. So Geiger will send it wide and get off to Wesley Phillips and the Pioneers will get the clear. Over to Lawrence. Back out to Kirkham. Brown to Raymond. And it'll be a turnover coming up against Tusculum as Phillips was unable to handle the pass by Raymond. So fourth turnover of the night for TU. And we're going to have another turnover just on the routine pass by Cruz, as Cesaro is unable to control it. So some sloppy play on that last exchange on back-to-back turnovers by each team. Rodney Tapp in his first season for Tusculum, in his fifth year with the Bobcats, Brad Dunn on the sidelines in Banner Elk. Five minutes remaining in this first half. Just outside the crease, Kirkham back up top to Lawrence. Lawrence over to Brown. Being closely guarded by Finley. Shot by Lawrence. Brown. Wide. And coming up with the ground ball pickup is Tusculum. 55 seconds remaining in this shot clock. Shot and save by Cruz as Kirkham tried to go to the near post, but he's blocked away by Cruz. The Panthers will get the reset again. Kale Lawrence sends it back way up near midfield to Sean Dunn. Dunn. Shot. Deflected. Back to Tusculum. 28 seconds remaining on the shot clock. Tristan Kirkham. DeKale Lawrence over to Brown. Brown back to Lawrence. Going low and going in is Tristan Kirkham. So a low side shot bounced in, just goes to the inside the far post. Second goal of the night for Tristan Kirkham. I think we're going to give the assist to Lawrence. Let's see what.
Looks
like that's going to be unassisted. So unassisted goal to Tristan Kirkham. And the Pioneers now lead 12-4. Face-off win coming up for Lees McCray. Long shot by the and possession now goes to Lees McCray. Trailing 12-4, approaching a 3-minute mark of this first half. Again, we are glad to have you with us here watching on the Pioneer Sports Network. Ball is free, but coming up with it is Tyler Finley. And he'll get it back up top. It's Cade Andrus. Now back to Jake M. And we've got a whistle. And it looks like we're going to have a crease violation charged against Lees McCray. And it'll be possession going to the Pioneers. High pass, but coming up with the ground ball pickup is Kale Lawrence. And back to Kirkham, and we'll work this one down. Tusculum leading 12-4. Just shy of 2 minutes remaining in this first half. Tuscum scoring 10 first quarter goals. We've been three total goals scored in this quarter. Two by Tusculum, one by Lees McCray. Let's make that three for Tusculum as the Pioneers get the goal. I believe that'll be Jordan Daniel with the goal. Says with a question mark.
That's us from goal number 17. Jordan Daniel, assist number 33, Kale Lawrence.
So Jordan Daniel with the goal, credit the assist to Kale Lawrence. So Kale having a good night with a goal and an assist. Four goals each by Lawrence Brown and Nate Raymond. Ball free in front of the Tusculum bench. Quick restart by Lees McCray. That's going to be a turnover against Lees McCray. That'll be their seventh of the night. So the Pioneers, with the gift, will try to add to this 13-4 lead. And the Pioneers give it back on the high pass. So 1:04 remaining. And another turnover. So a lot of offense in that first quarter, but a lot of turnovers in this one. 14th combined turnover. Seven each. Again, Tusculum will be in action on Saturday when it will be at Emmanuel. We got a penalty coming up against the Bobcats. And then they'll close out the month against Alabama Huntsville next Saturday here at Pioneer Field. Wrap up February and also wrap up the non-conference schedule before beginning conference play on March the 5th against Mars Hill. So the whistle blows with 1.2 seconds remaining. This should pretty much almost wrap it up.
Lees McCray penalty number 11, Tyler Finley, 30-second tactical for offside.
So penalty against Lees McCray, offside. It's not a whole lot you can do with it here for Tusculum. And that'll end the first half. Your score after 30 minutes of play, it's Tusculum 13, Lees McCray 4. You're watching Tusculum lacrosse on the Pioneer Sports Network.
Tusculum 13 and Lees McCray 4.
Pioneer Field. Pioneers are in action tonight at North Greenville. Was not looking good for the Pioneers in that one, as that one was heading down the final moments. The Pioneers were down by 8 with about 3 minutes remaining. Other scores in Tusculum action today. Women's basketball winning a big game on the road at Lincoln Memorial, winning 51-43. So a big win for the Pioneers as they try to get on the board and get into the South Atlantic Conference tournament. Men's basketball will return back to action after about 2 weeks off when they take on Lincoln Memorial, the 8th-ranked team in the country, tomorrow night, 7 o'clock from Tex Turner Arena. We're back to lacrosse action. Pioneers leading 13-4. Pioneers going on the man-up advantage to open up this third period of action. Brown with the shot, and Brown with the goal. Lawrence Brown with the goal. Makes it 14-4 Tusculum. As Brown picks up goal number 5.
And a Pioneer man of goal scored by number 7, Lawrence Brown. Assist number 21, Tristan Kirkham.
Kirkham coming up with the assist for TU. His second of the night. The Pioneers now lead by 10. And back the other way comes Tusculum on the faceoff win. The Pioneers scored on the man-up advantage, which carried over from the second quarter. And a goal for Tusculum. They're going to say no goal. Be offsides against TU. We had two whistles going at simultaneously. That's why we're kind of holding up on that one. But Tusculum coming on the offside, so no goal. And back come Lees McCray on the possession, trailing. And we got a penalty coming way off, and that'll go to Tusculum. So Nicholas Drennan's goal is taken off the board on the offside. So it's Linnelli. Up front, shot wide, out of play, whistle will blow, and then we'll have the penalty assessed against Tusculum. So for the second time tonight,
66, Nate Raymond, the 30-second technical for offside.
So Nate Raymond will be whistled 30-second penalty for offside. So on the man-up advantage will go the Bobcats, trailing in this one 14-4. Back up front. Low, wide, past Geiger. Still time on this man up advantage for Lees McCray. Should be coming in the final seconds here. And stays just in, and Raymond's penalty is over, and back to even strength are the Pioneers and Bobcats. Bobcats still on the possession. 15 seconds remaining on this shot clock. Spence Combs is going to have to shoot. Will the Bobcats get off a shot? They will not. So the shot clock violation against the Bobcats. Pioneers hold. And will now go on the attack. Dunn trying to find it. Comes up with the scoop. Nice little nifty move. Shot and a goal by, looks like Nate had it. I believe he did. Yes, it is. Nate Raymond with the goal.
Minor goal, number 66, Nate Raymond.
So Nate Raymond, he gets his fifth of the night. Gives him 18 on the season in just four games. Makes it 15-4 in favor of the Pioneers. Looks like I have a turnover against Tusculum, and back the other way come the Bobcats. Down 11. Tyler Flanelli, excuse me, makes the move. He is taken out. Still possession to Lees McCray, 50 seconds remaining. Galloway, that one goes wide. Foot race to the ball. Coming up with it is Lees McCray. Still plenty of time. Loses it after picking it up is Combs. He'll get it off to Finley. And Finley will set it up with 33 seconds remaining in this shot clock. That's Ryan Bird. Gets off the shot, smothering it in the crease. And coming out of the crease is Geiger. Finds Kirkham on the move. Correction, that was Caldwell, T.J. Caldwell. Got a little left tap as he's heading out, and the Pioneers will reset it up. Phillips over to Lawrence. Off to the far side. Back to Nate Raymond. Surveys, loses it. I believe we got a penalty on the ground. Let's see who this one's against. Looks like it'll be against Lees McCray. Their fourth infraction of the game.
Lees McCray penalty number 29, Casey Cesaro, 1 minute for slashing.
So a 1 minute slashing penalty against Cesaro, and that'll be Pioneers going the up. Man up advantage here for the next 60 seconds. Sean Dunn. Over to Raymond. Back to Lawrence. Dunn loses it. Still has not possessed it. Can't find it, but Tristan Kirkham will come up with it. Second time that Dunn has lost it and couldn't seem to find it on the ground. Over to Brown. Inside to Lawrence, and Lawrence with the goal. So Kale Lawrence with the goal. Give the assist to Lawrence Brown as he threaded that pass.
Tusculum man up goal line number 33, Kale Lawrence. Assist number 7, Lawrence Brown.
So second goal of the night for Lawrence Brown. for Cale Lawrence. And for Brown, his first assist going along with five goals. Pioneers come up with the faceoff win. Kalski gives it off to Will Cookman. Goes wide. Finds Phillips. Phillips gets it back out front, and the Pioneers will set up the attack, leading 16-4. Again, Lees McCray jumped out to an early 2-0 lead. Pioneers score four and answered before giving up a goal to Lees McCray to make it 4-3, and then Tuscombe opened up the floodgates. Took the 13-4 lead into the locker room. And we get a whistle, and it'll be a foul against Lees McCray. And so Tusculum will have it. We get a fresh 60, and we get a timeout coming up to believe Tusculum will call this. So timeout Tusculum, 7:56 remaining in the third period. Your score, Tusculum 16, Lees McCray 4. This is Tusculum Lacrosse on the Pioneer Sports Network. To 4 your score, 7:56 remaining in the third quarter. Again, glad to have you with us here on the Pioneer Sports Network. Our next broadcast here on the network will be on Friday with men's volleyball. Pioneers take on Fort Valley State. That'll be a turnover against Tusculum. Then our Saturday menu, got a lot of events at home. We'll have the basketball doubleheader here on the network between Tusculum and Coker. Women's game beginning at 2:00, and then we'll have the women's lacrosse home opener also. That will be at 1:00, again here on the Pioneer Sports Network. And then we'll close out the weekend with baseball. On Sunday afternoon, 12:00, Pioneers taking on nationally ranked Molloy College out of New York. They're playing Molloy in a three-game series over Pioneer Park. So back to live action. Tusculum leading by a dozen. Dislodged shot, goes wide. Fifteen seconds remaining on this shot clock. Wide goes Lees McCray with the shot and the save by Ross Geiger. Save number 7 for Ross. come the Pioneers. And we're going to have a turnover. And back comes Lees McCray. Flanelli. He stopped. Galloway dislodged from the ball. Pioneers come up with it, give it back, and Lees McCray back on the attack. So Lees McCray gave it away. Pioneers went ahead and reciprocated. And so Lees McCray will go ahead and just set it up. And there's about 5:30 remaining in this third quarter. Spence Combs. Back out to Flanelli. Excuse me, Bird. Back out to Combs. Shot low, wide. On the restart, with 30 seconds remaining on the shot clock. That one's blocked up front in front of Geiger. Still leaves McCray ball. 22 seconds remaining on the clock to shoot. Finley. That one goes across the mouth of the goal. And that'll be a restart on the 60-second shot clock. New rule this year in men's lacrosse. That one is blocked as Combs' shot was dislodged, but Pioneers had it briefly. The Pioneers are going to get a penalty, probably for a high stick. Happened right in front of us here. So Galloway stopped up front. Pioneers possess, but that will stop the clock with the penalty coming up against the Pioneers. Could be a high stick, could be a slash. We will get the official call.
Personal penalty number 13, Will Cookman, a 30-second technical for a hold.
So it'll be a hold. He was holding with the high stick. So third man up advantage on the night for Lees McCray, with him trailing 16-4 here in the final minutes of this third period. Blast and caught by Ross Geiger, making the nifty save. Geiger goes into double digits and saves. Pioneers work it across, get it to Dunn. And a penalty is over, back to even strength. So a great save on the man up advantage, on the man down advantage for TU by Geiger. Dunn sends it out to Jordan Daniel. Nate Raymond, his shot goes wide. 25 seconds remaining on the shot clock. Sean Dunn. That one's deflected, but Daniel will maybe have time to get it. He does. 3 seconds, 2, 1, and that'll be it. So shot clock violation against Tusculum. That'll be their first of the night. 2:17 and counting in this third period, excuse me. And Taken down goes Finley. And the turnover. The Pioneers on the quick restart. They will not be able to come up with it as Cruz comes out of the crease. And he'll step on the line, and that will give it back to Tusculum. So nice defensive play by Cruz. Did not complete it as he stepped out of bounds. He gives it back to Tusculum, but getting the Pioneers on the quick attack after the turnover in midfield. Shot went low, went wide. It'll be Tusculum ball. Lawrence Brown. Off to Nate Raymond. Top two scorers tonight for Tusculum. High pass to Lawrence, but he comes down with it. And we've got a crease, a violation, looks like. I'd say that was probably against Phillips. But Tusculum comes up with the turnover. Tusculum with numbers. Brown, saved by Cruz. Tusculum comes up with the rebound. Seconds remaining in this quarter. Whistle. It looks like it's going to be against. So 11 seconds remaining in the quarter. Brown will have to get the shot off. It is blocked up front. And we've got a penalty coming up. Less than 1 second remaining in this quarter. See who it's against. Looks like it'll be against Lees McCray. And that will end the third period of play. 45 minutes in the books. We head to the fourth and final quarter. Your score at the end of three, Tusculum 16.
These were great four.
You're watching Tusculum Lacrosse on the Pioneer Sports Network. About ready to start the fourth quarter. Other action in Tusculum Athletics today, it was the Tusculum softball team. Game you saw here on the Pioneer Sports Network swept a home doubleheader against North Greenville, winning 9-2 and 9-4. So congratulations to the Tusculum women, off to an 8-2 start to the 2022 season, defending Southland Conference Tournament champions. Pioneers back at it now with the man advantage after the penalty. Up front, top shot, goal. So Kirkham with the blast, goes far post.
That final goal by number 21, Tristan Kirkham. Assist number 66, Nate Raymond.
And Nate Raymond picks up his first assist of the night. So for Kirkham, goal number 3 of the contest. Back to Lawrence, up front, or up top, excuse me. Goes to Will Cookman. Caskey sends it back up top. Tusculum resetting. Raymond with the shot. And Cruz with the save. So Cruz makes his 13th save tonight. The numbers were in favor of the Bobcats, but the Tusculum defense comes back and slows down the attack. Since giving up 3 goals in the first quarter, the Pioneers have only allowed 1 goal. They blanked the Bobcats in the third. They're doing the same so far here in the fourth. Quick restart. Geiger, critical error, empty goal as Geiger gave that one away. Terrible pass by Geiger. No, that does not make Coach Tapp happy. Has his hands on his hips right now and not happy with that play by a senior netminder.
Please be afraid, goal by number 9, Ryan Berg.
So Ryan Berg gets the goal. And for Bird, his 2nd of the contest. That'll be less scooped up initially, but Pioneers still get it. And we'll get off to Lawrence, and Pioneers will set it up again. 17-5, your score. Tusculum looking to move to 4-0 on the season, before hitting the road on Saturday for a non-conference contest down in Franklin Springs against Emmanuel. Shot wide by Nate Raymond. He's had a 5-goal night, as has Lawrence Brown. To Dunn, and coming up with the goal after the Dunn assist is Tristan Kirkham.
Final goal, number 21, Tristan Kirkham. Assist number 8, Sean Dunn.
So Kirkham with goal number 4 tonight. Sean Dunn picks up his first point of the evening with the assist. as Tusculum extends the lead now to 18-5. Pioneers out shooting the Bobcats 38-22, 31-15 with shots on goal. Coming up with their sixth face-off win are the Bobcats. And then we've got a player down for Lees McCray. Hobbling off is Ferreter, sophomore from Maryland. So penalty coming up against the Pioneers. Still on the attack are the Bobcats. Flanelli. That's Ryan Bird. Just scored for the Bobcats. Shot and a goal by J.P. Galloway. Galloway gets one by Geiger. Makes it 18-6. With Tusculum still leading.
Goal number three, J.P. Galloway. Assist number 22, Spence Combs.
And Spence Combs will come up with the assist for the visitors from Banner Elk.
Tusculum penalty number 13, Will Cookman, 1 minute first slash.
So Cookman with the penalty, 1 minute for slashing. Here we go, so goal by Lees McCray, and they will go on the attack, leading 18-6. Have not put the goal up on the scoreboard yet. Pioneers with the face-off win. A man down, now it goes up. No correction, it's not up. I think that's right. Tusculum, a man down, trying to work off this rest of this penalty on Will Cookman. And also trying to get a man down goal. Which would be their first of the season. Sean Dunn, back to even strength, looking for Phillips in front. He'll take the shot himself off the side of the net. Kel Lawrence had a great opportunity to lay somebody out in a game like this. Goal by Tusculum. Kirkham again after the turnover. So the Pioneers are 19 goals, second most this season. Pioneers had 20 against Chouan in their last outing, and we got a timeout coming.
Pioneer goal scorer number 21, Tristan Kirkham.
Looks like it'll be a timeout going against Tusculum. So 9 minutes and 11 seconds remaining in this one. Tusculum leading 19-6 over Lees McCray. This is Tusculum Lacrosse on the Pioneer Sports Network. And we're out of the timeout called by Tusculum. Faceoff coming up for TU, leading 19-6. Win by the Pioneers. Off to Lawrence. Lawrence thought about it. Nate Raymond did it. That one goes wide. And the possession now continues with Tusculum here on the attack. So Ross Geiger out of the game for Tusculum. Riley Sims getting the time and goal. Got the start again Shorter. Picked up the win and the victory over Shorter. Had some outstanding saves in that one in his first collegiate start. That one goes wide and over the head of Caskey, and it'll be a turnover. 16th of the game charged against the Pioneers. Point blank, pass Sims into the goal for Lees McCray is number 17, Jake M. So M.
Lees McCray goal by number 17, Jake M. Assisted by number 3, J.P. Galloway.
And J.P. Galloway comes up with the assist. So seventh goal of the night for the Bobcats and makes it 19-7. Under 8 minutes remaining in this one. After tonight, Lees McCray will be back home for, they begin a three-game homestand, taking on Pfeiffer, and then with matches against Davis and Elkins and Young Harris before opening Conference Carolina's play on March 23rd against North Greenville. We mentioned earlier, this is the fourth consecutive match against South Atlantic Conference teams for the Bobcats that played Queens, Mars Hill, and Newberry previously, all losses. And that's intercepted. And back the other way, quickly come the Bobcats. Dropped by Finley, but still has time to gather it in. But stops the quick counter by the Bobcats. Again, trailing by 12. Shot stopped by Sims. Still leaves McCray ball. Back out front to Bird. Bird takes a hard shot. That one go wide. Still going to be possession to the Bobcats. As it was a foot race between Sims and Tyler Finley. Looks like Finley won that one. Still free. Sims comes way off out of the box. He throws that one in a little bit of a panic and they'll turn it over. So the 18th turnover by Tusculum. Ball's free in the crease. Sims with it. And back out comes Tusculum. Brent Floyd. Daniel, Lawrence, point blank for getting the ball. Well, not for getting the ball, but it just slipped out of the stick. And the penalty flags come out again. And we get the whistle. Lisa McCray trying for the quick restart, but so fifth penalty coming up against the Pioneers tonight. So with the man up advantage comes the Bobcats. Fair, they're trying to find Finley. Fair, that drops it. Still able to pick it up. That's Ryan Bird. To Bird. Shot wide by Galloway. With the blast and the goal is Finley. Tyler Finley with the goal. So Finley picks up his first goal tonight. And 4:13 remaining, your new score, Tuscaloosa 19, Lee's McCray 8.
Tyler Finley, assistant to 3, J.P. Galloway.
Looking at the stats, 44 shots for Tusculum, 28 for Lee's McCray, 34 shots on goal by the Pioneers, and 19 by the Bobcats. We saw violation against the Bobcats, so the Pioneers get their 23rd faceoff win tonight. Pioneers need one more goal to match a season high. That coming on Saturday against Chawan. Pioneers were up big in that one, but gave up some late goals to the Hawks. And turnover by Tusculum. Finley, because Galloway was wide open, but pass was just a little bit off target. Looks like we got somebody down for, looks like that was Finley. He was laboring up when he was laboring trying to get up. Looks like we're going to have... Looks like I got a timeout coming. And a penalty. Looks like we got a couple of penalties. See two or three of them out, so we'll get this cleaned up here. We'll let you know about it when we come out of this timeout. We got 3 minutes remaining. Tusculum leading 19-8 over Lee's McCray. This is Tusculum Lacrosse on the Pioneer Sports Network. Just a little over 3 minutes remaining in this one. Tuscan leading 19-8 over Leeds McRae. Looks like we're going to have matching penalties coming up against both teams. Tuscan might be. See a lot of bodies. So it'll be Tuscan possession. Got a penalty against Tusculum's Devin Bowen and a unsportsmanlike conduct against Galloway and a goal by the Pioneers.
And that Pioneer goal is scored by number 3, Aiden Caskey.
So Aiden Caskey with the goal. So Caskey playing in his second game of the season, picks up his first goal of 2022 to give Tusculum their 20th goal of the night. Pioneers get the faceoff win, 2:42 remaining. As we get this one restarted. Off to Lawrence. Tuscan will go to 4-0 on the season, while Leeds McRae will drop to 0-4. We'll have a penalty against, not penalty, but a turnover against Tuscan. Tuscan will be on the road on Saturday. They travel to Conference Carolina's member Emmanuel. That one will begin at 2:00. And we'll have a busy day here on this weekend, Friday and Saturday, with action here on the PSN with men's volleyball on Friday, followed by basketball on Saturday with a doubleheader, and also women's lacrosse, as head coach Jenna Augustino makes her Pioneer Field debut this coming Saturday. So the Pioneers working it around, trying to milk the remaining 60 seconds of this one. Kale Lawrence loses it, and coming away with it's Leeds McRae. Shot and a save. So it looks like the Pioneers will get off to their second consecutive 4-0 start, and would be looking for their first 5-0 start when they go to Emmanuel. In program history. So the last 15 seconds counting down in this one. Five seconds remaining. Shot by Bird and a save by Sims, and that will take care of it. So your final score, Tusculum 20 and Leeds McRae 8. Pioneers outshoot the Bobcats 45-30, 35-20 on shots on goal. Five goals each by Nate Raymond and Lawrence Brown. as well as Tristan Kirkham. So the Pioneers go to 4-0 on the season, and they'll look for their first 5-0 start in program history coming up Saturday when they travel to Emmanuel. And glad to have you with us for a full recap of tonight's contest. We'd like to visit our website at TuscanPioneers.com. Again, your final score, Tuscan 20 and Leeds McCurry 8. You've been watching Tuscan.